the church say amen.
Amen.
Come on, we can do better than that. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. This is a day that the Lord has made. He said, let us rejoice.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us rejoice.
Yes.
And be glad in it. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. How many of y'all know that God loves you? How many folks come in here this morning to worship the Lord?
Warrior. Yeah.
How many folks? All right, now, this is going to catch you. How many folks come in here this morning to praise the Lord?
Yeah.
Amen, somebody. Amen. Let us stand on our feet and give God a hand of praise.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. I tell you this, that today is the day that the Lord has made.
Amen.
I tell you, we are blessed to be able to come into his house.
Yes.
And lift up his name. Right. Amen, somebody. Amen.
Amen.
You know, I didn't come to stand up here to give y'all a show.
Come on now.
I didn't come stand up here so y'all can applaud George Ross.
Come on, Ross.
I came here to lift up the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody hear me this morning.
Amen.
Somebody hear me this morning.
Yeah.
If you come in here this morning to sit down and relax, you're in the wrong place.
Right. Praise God. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. We all have something to give to the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
If the Lord has blessed you this week, you ought to stand on your feet and give him a hand for you.
Yeah.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Yeah.
We're gonna be blessed this morning. We're going to be blessed this morning. We got our men's choir, and they're going to bless us with a word. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Y'all can be seated. Let's turn it over to these men of God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Pray for them. Amen.
Amen.
I can get so excited sometimes. I thank God. I thank God for my pastor, all right? He keeps me on that level right there.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Let us all stand so we can worship in the Holy Spirit this morning. Father God, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
We come this morning to give you the highest praise.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We love you this morning.
Yes.
So Holy Spirit, we invite you into this place.
Yes.
We invite you in to have your way.
Yes.
Have your way not just in this place, but in our spirits.
Yes. Yes.
Lift us up, Holy Spirit.
Yes.
We praise you and we worship you.
Yes.
So right now, in the name of Jesus,
yes,
we just ask you, Holy Spirit, to have your way into each and every one of us. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now we're going to hear a word from this man choir.
All right, Brother Lee. Give me a little volume, man. This means war. Hey, you had to start that again. You skipped something. War. This means war. This means war. I got joy in my soul. God is in control. I got Satan on my tail, but I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day. I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war. I got joy in my soul, God is in control. I got Satan on my tail, but I'm saying all is well. He's attacking every day, I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back. This means war. This means. And another thing, y'all, I plead the blood.
I plead the blood.
There's power in the blood.
I plead the
Healing in the blood.
Power
in the blood.
I've
been the storm and the rain.
Well,
blessed just stays the same.
Well,
whatever's going wrong.
Well,
I got my war clothes on.
Well,
I might be in a daze.
Well,
but you can't have my praise.
Well,
no matter the attack, I won't turn back.
This means war.
This means. I plead the blood, y'all.
I plead the blood.
There's power in the blood.
I plead the blood.
Healing in the blood.
I plead the blood.
There's power in the blood.
I plead the blood.
And another thing, you can't have my family.
No, you can't. No, you can't. No, you can't.
You can't have my increase. You can't have my, you can't have my, you can't, you can't. I plead the blood.
I plead the blood.
There's power in the blood.
I plead the blood.
Healing in the blood.
Oh, you might as well put those hands together.
There's power in the blood.
I plead the blood.
This means war.
Battlefield. Huh? We are on the battlefield.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Let us all rest on our feet while we read this morning's scripture. This morning's scripture will be coming from Psalms the 91st. Psalms 91. Psalms 91. I will be reading from the New International Version. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. When we find these words, he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty.
Yes.
I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. And he will cover you with his feathers and under his wings, and you will find refuge.
Yes.
His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart.
Yes.
Amen. You will not fear the terror of night.
Oh, no.
Yes. Nor the arrow that flies by day.
Yes, sir.
Nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness.
Right.
Nor the plagues that destroys at midday.
Yes.
1,000 may fall at your side.
Mm.
10,000 at your right hand.
Yes.
But it will not come near you. Amen, somebody.
Amen. Amen.
You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked.
Mm.
If you make the Most High your dwelling, even the Lord, who is my refuge,
yes,
then no harm will befall you.
Come on.
No disaster will come near your tent, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone.
Amen.
Amen. May God add a blessing to the hearers and doers of his most holy word. Amen, somebody. Amen. At this time, we're going to have our welcome. Somebody's going to come up this morning and give us, amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. We like to welcome you, Jesus Christ. Like to welcome you, family. Like to welcome you, visitors. I love all of you. Now we will have remarks by our pastor, Bobby A. Bowser.
Amen.
God bless you. Thank you so kindly for the welcome this morning to everybody. I think everybody's at home this morning. And I'm going to ask you, for those of you at home this morning, to pray for those who are not here this
Amen.
Morning.
Amen.
Because they need to be here in the house of the Lord. The word just tells us they who dwell in the what? Shadow of the Almighty
All
shall
right.
abide. Amen.
Amen.
So we ought to be here together to worship the Lord together. If you don't mind this morning, stand right where you are. Come on, stand on your feet this morning once again. I know that you don't like to keep standing, but I want you to stand this morning because God's given you legs that you can stand. You ought to use them. Mm-hmm. You ought to use them because we're going to pray right now.
Amen.
We're going to pray for us, and then we're going to pray for others who are less fortunate than we are. I don't know if you know it or not, but every morning that I wake up, I'm cognizant that I didn't have to wake up this morning.
Amen.
Every morning that I able to get out of the bed and put one foot in front of the other, I'm cognizant that the Lord could have taken that privilege from me on last night because somebody didn't get up on this morning. Okay. Somebody this morning, the mortician came to pick them up, to take them, to unroll them to their resting place. But you ought to praise God because it's not you this morning.
Amen.
You ought to thank God because he blessed you once again.
Amen.
And you don't know what a privilege it is to wake up, to have your health and strength. And as the old saints' time would say, I've got the activity of my limbs, health and strength, a reasonable portion of health. So we ought to be grateful this morning. Join me now as we pray. And that I want you to bow your heads and pray for somebody that you know that's less fortunate than you are this morning. They may be in a nursing home this morning. They may be home this morning. They may be right now in the hospital. But we're going to pray for them this morning because it could have been us that's there. Join me in prayer. Almighty and eternal God, our Father, we thank you now for blessing us.
Yes.
People here at Mount Lebanon Baptist Church.
Yes,
Father. And we can come on this morning to praise your name.
Yes.
We know that you are a holy God and that yet we are sinful creatures. But we thank you that even though we fall short and we miss the mark every now and then, we're thankful, God, that you've given us your word that if we would confess our sins, that you would be faithful to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And so, God, anything that we've done outside of your will or your way now, forgive us right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes, yes.
Now, God, I pray for this sin-sick world in which we live in. We do realize that we're having wars and rumors of war going on all around us. But, God, you told us in your word that this would happen. And so, God, we are not surprised because your word is true. And all we have to do is to enlighten ourselves in your word, God. We know that if we enlighten ourselves in your word says that you will give us the desires of our heart this morning.
Amen.
So our desire this morning, God, is that that you would come and bless as you can only do, God.
Yes.
That individual right now that's pains in their bodies, that racking their bodies right now. God, that you would bring forth healing in the name of Jesus. An individual that's grieving right now because of the loss of a loved one, that you would come and comfort this morning in the name of Jesus. That individual right now, God, that's going through some trials and some tribulations right now, that they can't quite seem to see their way through right now. God, that you would draw near to them right now in the name of Jesus, and be that comforter that they need right now. And God, we know that you can do it because your track record has already proven to us, God, what you can do. So we thank you, God, for the track record this morning, that knowing that you are a faithful God. And matter of fact, your word even says that you were faithful when we were faithless. When we didn't even have any faith, God, you were faithful to your children. So this morning, God, we come right now laying off burdens, laying our cares, laying, God, everything that we have at the foot of the cross this morning and asking you, God, to minister right now in the name of Jesus. This morning, we thank you for your son, Jesus, who died that we may have a right to the tree of life this morning, that when we die on this side, God, that we would have eternal life on the other side because of your son, Jesus, this morning. We thank you for the blood that he shed this morning. We thank you for the agony of the cross that he went through on this morning, God, for he took our place. That agony belonged to us. That suffering belonged to us. That beating belonged to us, God. But because of who he was and because of why you sent him, God, he took our place.
on the old rugged cross. So God, we thank you now for Jesus this morning. Now, God, I pray that you would bless this country called America, that we would get our act together and that we will repent and turn our faces back unto you. Because your word tells us that if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven. I'll forgive their sins and heal their land. So, God, we repent right now in the name of Jesus. The people in Israel right now are hurting, God. Go by right now and be a battle axe for them. Fight the battle for them in the name of Jesus. You are Jehovah Nissi. You are the one that fights our battles. Now, God, bless Mount Lebanon Baptist Church. We are maybe be the people that you called us to be. People loving one another, but most of all, people loving you and showing forth the love of Christ on the inside of us. We thank you now for what you have done, for that in which you're doing, and for that in which you're about to do. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
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 And amen. God bless you. You may take your seats.
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today.
What?
Because you care for me. In such a special way, that's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise.
Amen, amen.
I love you.
All right.
I love you. I love you, Lord, today.
All right.
Because you care for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is
Do something for me, Mount Lebanon, those of you who are here. Those of you who are here, look around. There's a lot of folks who are missing. Mount Lebanon has been blessed. Even through COVID, we were still open. Amen, amen somebody. I encourage everyone sitting here today to reach out. Call someone this week. Talk to someone this week. We're a small congregation. Everybody knows somebody in here. Amen?
Amen.
Pick up the phone this week and call and encourage them to come back to God's house. Amen.
Amen.
Amen somebody. Amen. Amen. At this time we have announcements this morning. The Dorcas Ministry. The Dorcas Ministry. We're in need. The Bible tells us to go and help. To be a help to someone else. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And we are in, excuse me, we are in need of some items. Winter is approaching, cold weather is approaching. We are in need of blankets. You see the things on the screen. Personal hygiene items. Long johns. Y'all know what long johns are, right?
Yes, sir.
Long johns, hats, gloves, socks, and we can always use a monetary blessing. Amen. Because what we do, I don't know the church, I don't know if you guys realize, but what we do in the Dorcas Ministry, we actually serve two different places. We serve one over on right off of Monticello, where folks are actually sleeping in tents, in cardboard boxes. They're in need, y'all. They're in need. So we encourage you. We also serve down on Campostella Avenue on the third Thursdays of each month, where we provide meals for 50 or 60 of our brothers and sisters without shelter. They're in need, y'all. They're in need. So those who would, if God placed it upon your heart, please, please donate to these items. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Also, ministry heads. We had a meeting a couple months ago, and it was asked that all ministry heads would meet with their ministries, auxiliaries, and come up with your plan for next year. So if you would see me after service today, we have some forms for you to fill out, because what we want to do, we want to fill out our calendar for next year so that there will be no mishaps, nobody overstepping anyone. The calendar will be set for next year. So right after the service this morning, come see me so that you can get a form to fill out after you meet with your ministry or while you're meeting with your ministry. Amen? Also, church anniversary is coming up next month. We're having a family showcase. Family showcase on November 11th. There's a sign-up sheet out in the back. Everybody here got some kind of talent. Huh? Hey, amen. It's all about having fun, y'all. Excuse me. It's all about having fun. Y'all want to see, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to be doing. I'm gonna be a stand-up comic. Amen.
Amen.
I'm also gonna sing. Amen, somebody. Huh? I know you wanna leave me, but I refuse to let you go. If I have to beg and plead for your sympathy, I'll leave it alone. Y'all got a taste of it, right? I can't sing, but it's all about having fun. Amen? Amen. So I encourage everyone to sign up out there on the sign-up sheet. Just bring your talent. Just come on in and have a good time. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. At this time, we're gonna have an announcement by Sister. Yeah. A brain freeze. That's all
Cynthia,
it is.
Cynthia Yule.
Yeah, amen. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. There's some flyers around the building, but I'm also encourage those people who are out there in listening land to join us next Sunday. We're trying to recognize, in recognition of breast cancer awareness, we're asking everybody to show up next week with some pink on. I see a lot of pink today, so you can recycle it for next week or find you a new outfit. So come out and join us and wear your pink to recognize Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Thank you.
Amen, amen, amen. Hey, Sister Cynthia, that's for everybody, right? Amen, amen. Rhonda, you hear that? I got to go get me some pink. Amen, amen. This time, we're gonna go ahead and move on with the service. We're going to have one or two more selections from this choir. One more. Amen. One more selection from this choir. And then after they come back with that selection, how many of y'all ready for the word?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. After this selection from the choir, the next voice you hear will be that of our own Pastor Bowser. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let church say sing, choir.
Amen. Amen, church. We're going to go back to old school.
Uh-huh.
We want you to go to your hymn books.
Yeah.
If you got a hymn book, pull it out.
Come on, pull it out.
We're going to
page
339 in your hymn book. Because we do need the Lord.
Amen.
We need the Lord to take our hand.
Uh-huh. Yes.
And lead us.
Yes.
Because some of us walking around with blinders on.
Yes.
And we need God to lead us.
Yes.
Not man.
Because
so man can only lead you to destruction.
That's right.
But God can lead you to eternal life. Amen?
Amen.
All right, so we're going to do it the old school way. We're going to do it straight out the book, no music. We're going to let God run this. Come on. Amen?
Amen.
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 All right, here we go.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storms, through the night,
praise be unto our God on this day and all that God has done, all that God is doing on this day. Come on, bless God for the men this morning. Amen. Amen. Praise God for them on this day. Can we bless God for Reverend Ross, our worship leader, on today? On today, amen. Praise be unto our God on today. Come on, bow your heads and join with me. Let's pray this morning. Gracious God, our Father, how we love you, how we thank you, how we praise you. There's nobody like you, God. Nobody can do us like you do us, Lord. We ask right now, by the aid of your Holy Spirit, that you come now and enter into this place and enter into these cold hearts of ours, that we may do thy blessed will. Lead us now. Speak to me and speak through me. Lord, let me say it right. Lord, let them hear it right. Lord, let us do it right. Now may the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, let it be acceptable in thy sight. You are my strength, you are my redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise be unto our God this morning. Scripture this morning came from Psalms 91. Psalms 91. If you go back there with me at verse number 1, you'll hear these words coming from the NIV. And the psalmist says this morning from the NIV, whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. Now, if I could read the King James Version, it would say it like this. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Amen.
Amen.
From that verse right there, I want to talk this morning just for a little while from the subject, staying close to the Lord. Staying close to the Lord. If you look at the Gospel of Mark around chapter 24, Matthew chapter 24, or Mark chapter 13, the Bible has recorded words to us that Jesus spoke. And Jesus said, when you hear of wars and rumors of wars, see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is not yet. Let me give you that again. He says, when you hear of wars and rumors of wars, see to it that you are not alarmed. Don't get upset. Don't get frustrated. He says, such things must happen, but the end is not yet. I give that to you this morning because people will now run to you and tell you that the Bible says that when you hear wars and rumors of wars, then that is sign of the end. That's not what the scripture says. Let's get to the scripture of what the scripture says. Jesus says these things must happen, but that's not the end yet. These things are just signs that have to happen, but don't get alarmed with you because you see wars and you hear of rumors of wars, but the end is not yet. Well, if we see that we have in wars and we hear of rumors of wars because there are other nations now are talking about warring, and when we see and we hear about other nations talking about warring, we have to understand that the Bible is just true. It is coming to pass right now. But I believe that if you hear that and you see that, a good thing that we ought to learn to do, first of all, if this is going on and I see this and I hear this, what I need to do, it's a good time for me to draw close to the Lord. If I know that Jesus says this is what's happening, and what's happening, the time of the end is not yet, but these are signs of things that must happen before the end comes, it's a good idea for us to draw close to the Lord now. Why is that, Reverend? It's because blessings comes to those who draw close to the Lord. Stay with me this morning. Blessings come to those who draw close to the Lord. Well, that's what the scripture says right there. He who dwells what? In the secret place, under the shadow of the Almighty, a blessing will come to them because they will abide what? Under the shadow of the Almighty. That's a blessing right now, and that's why I ought to draw close to the Lord. Well, let me tell you this, that sometimes because of our closeness to some folks, we get free stuff. Stay with me. Listen, there are times in our lives when we draw close to some folks, we get free stuff. And when we are close to other folks, and because of our closeness to them, we get free stuff. That's what you call the privilege of proximity. It's the privilege of
proximity. What do you mean, Pastor? What I mean is that the reason I'm getting what I'm getting is not because of what I've done or who I am. It's just because I'm with the right person. I'm around somebody, and because of their goodness and their success, some things come and fall over on me because of my proximity to them. You do understand today that it's a privilege to be connected to people who got it going on. It's a privilege to be connected to folks who have success, because if I draw close to them and they let me hold on to their coattail, hold on to their purse string, every now and then some dewdrops will fall over on me because of my closeness, of my proximity to them. Well, you must, if you can be honest this morning, all of us would say that I have gotten some blessings in life, not because of who I am, but who I have been connected to. As a matter of fact, I believe everybody in here today, if you just would be honest today, somebody would say, I am where I am today, not because of who I am or what I've done, but it's because of me being connected to somebody else that's got it going on. Well, sometimes you got to be in the right place at the right time, hanging out with the right people in order to get some privileges that you really don't even deserve. Yeah, this morning, that's called the privilege of proximity. It's my closeness to somebody else. Well, let's go to the text this morning, because the text this morning lets us know that some people who dwell under the shadow of the Almighty, when you dwell under the shadow of the Almighty, there are some perks and some privileges that come in dwelling under the shadow of the Almighty. Y'all missed that, but I'll come back. Y'all looking real confused this morning, like I'm talking in French or something like that. But you might as well come on and get with the program this morning, because you have to understand this morning that the scripture is correct. And the scripture says that if I dwell, what? In the secret place, under the shadow of the Almighty, some privileges will come my way. Well, the question this morning is, what are those privileges, Pastor? What are those privileges when I'm in the right place and I'm close to people who are successful? Well, Jesus, God says this morning that when you dwell close to me, there are some privileges that will come your way. What are the privileges, Pastor? Well, the first privilege this morning is when I draw close to him, the first privilege is that God will provide me a testimony. When I stay close to God, God will provide me, God will provide you with a testimony. Well, what's the testimony? It's right there in the text, Glory. It's right there. It's in verse number 2, Pam. It said that when I draw close to him, the testimony that he will give me this morning is that I will say he is my refuge and my fortress. That's the testimony that I will get when I get close to him. You see, the psalmist is suggesting that our time with the Lord shapes our testimony about the Lord. Our time with the Lord shapes our testimony about the Lord. You see, you can't spend time with the Lord and not come away with a testimony. You can't spend time with God and then walk away and you don't have a testimony, because when you spend time with God, God will put something down on the inside of your heart that when you walk away, you got to tell somebody about what the Lord has done. Psalmist this morning said, listen, my testimony is that he is my refuge. You see, in Numbers, the word refuge this morning is a Hebrew word that means shelter or security. He is my shelter. He is my security. In Numbers 35, verse 6 is the first time that we hear this word refuge in the Bible. Numbers 35 and 6 is the first time in the Bible that we hear of this word called refuge. And that scripture says, the cities that you give to the Levites shall be the six cities of refuge, where you shall permit the manslayers to flee. And in addition to them, you shall give 42 cities. Well, why is that, pastors? Why is it a refuge this morning? It's because those who worship the Lord will come under attack. And when they come under attack, it is the Lord that is your shelter. It is the Lord that is your security, because you do realize today that you will come under attack, don't you? So if you know that you're going to come under attack, it's a good thing to draw close to the Lord, that the Lord will provide a shelter and security for you, because the attack is coming. You see, worshipers receive a different level of attack than non-worshipers do. But when the devil attacks you, the Lord says, I'll be your refuge. I'll be the shelter. I'll be the security for you when the devil attacks you. But you got to understand that the devil is going to attack. And if you draw close to the Lord, he's your refuge and your shelter. But then you got to realize that Isaiah 59:19, the B clause, says, when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Lord will lift up a standard against him. In other words, what the Lord says is that when you draw close to me, I'll be the security. I'll be that refuge. I'll be that fortress for you, so the enemy can't do you no harm when the enemy draws close to you. Why? Because you got a testimony that he is my refuge. Preach, Bobby. He is my refuge. You got a refuge this morning. And if you spend time staying close with the Lord, he'll give you a testimony. Well, when I look back over my life, I can testify that he's been my refuge. Come on, talk to me, somebody. When you look back over your life, you realize he's been your refuge. He's been that shelter for you. He's been that security for you, because you do realize that there were times that the enemy attacked you and you didn't know where to run, because every time you look to your left or you look to your right, the enemy was right there. Matter of fact, when you turned around, the enemy was right there. And when you look straight ahead, the enemy was right there. But God put a covering over you. Tell somebody, he put a covering over me. He sheltered me. He gave me security from my enemies. And had God not been my shelter and my refuge and put a security on me, I wouldn't be here today. But because of the Lord. Because of the Lord gave me a shelter, gave me security, I'm here this morning. My testimony, he gives me a testimony. That's the first privilege, is that my testimony is God is my refuge. That's the first privilege. That's the first privilege. But the second privilege from the scripture this morning is this. It is, not only will God give you a testimony, but the second privilege is that he'll pull you from traps. It's in the text. He'll pull you from traps. Verse 3 says, God secures me. The King James Version says, surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. You see, our proximity with the Lord, our closeness with the Lord doesn't prevent us from traps, but he pulls us from the traps that we get in. That word deliver there means that he snatches. He snatches me away from the enemy. It describes a strong force usurping its power over a stronger force. And every now and then the devil will set some traps for you. But the good news is, the Bible says, the psalmist says, what he does for me is he snatches me from the traps of the enemy. He snatches me. He pulls me up from the trap that I have fallen into. And as a matter of fact, you might as well go and testify this morning, because some of y'all looking at me right now as if you ain't never fell in a trap. Some of the traps that you fell in were traps that you fell on your own in, because you weren't close to the Lord, so you fell in the trap. But somebody fell in some traps that the devil fell for you. When you fell in the trap, God snatched you out of the trap. And when you came out of the trap, you realize then that is God is a refuge and a strength, a very present help in the time of trouble. Pulls me, snatches me. Well, if you don't believe that you fall in a trap, ask Joseph. Joseph will tell you, my brothers put me in a pit, got sold off to the Ishmaelites, got sold off, then ended up in Pharaoh's house down there. But look at what the Lord did. All because the Lord was the one who really snatched me from the trap. The enemy could have come, the animals could have come and devoured me while I was in the trap right there, but the Lord snatched me out of the trap. God deserves our praise when he takes us out of the trap. When God delivers us, God deserves our praise. That's why the psalmist says in Psalm 107:2, he says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he has redeemed from the hands of the enemy. As a matter of fact, I'll get out my second point and tell you today that if you stay close to the Lord, you stay in his proximity, he will pull you from traps that the devil set for you. And the very trap the devil set for you, the enemy will fall in the same trap that they set for you. Why? It's because the Lord is my refuge. The Lord is my shelter. He's my security today. And the Lord delivers me. Any of y'all ever been delivered? Come on, talk to me this morning. Any of y'all really been delivered? That you know that the enemy set some traps for you, but God delivers you from the traps that the enemy set? And listen, can I tell you something today? The enemy doesn't mind setting traps for you, but the good news is that when I walk close to the Lord will show me the trap. The Lord will show me the trap sometime. And even, Tamika, if I slip, and I fall in the trap, I got a God that'll snatch me out of the trap. But the psalmist says right there, surely he will deliver me from the fowls of the pestilence. He will snatch me. He will snatch me. But that's a privilege that God gives those who stay close to him, who stay in proximity with him. That's why it's good to come to church. That's why it's good to come to church, to stay in proximity with the Lord. Now I'm not trying to say that you can't stay in proximity with the Lord watching it on Facebook or on YouTube. I'm not trying to say that to today. But what I am trying to say is simply this, and I'll make it plain for you. The church is the bride of Christ. The church is God's bride. And when you don't show up to God's bride, God may get upset with you. It's the bride of Christ. And you ought to come and love his bride, which is the people of God. Amen. Well, here it is. I'm done. Bible says, first of all, privilege number one is that God will give you a testimony. That God is my refuge and strength. He's our fortress. But then the second privilege is that he will pull you from traps. But the third privilege in the scripture this morning is simply this, is that he will protect you from terror. Y'all with me? He will protect you from terror. Look at verse 5. Verse 5 says, you will not fear the terror of the night. Y'all see that? You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrows that fly by day. Well, look at what it says about this word terror this morning. In other words, what is terror this morning? Terror is when the devil shoots arrows at you regularly. Paul calls them fiery dots. Paul calls them fiery dots. There were arrows that will take the psalmist says, that will fly to you during the daytime. But then he says there are pestilence that will stalk you at nighttime. But then he says that there are plagues that will destroy you at noontime. You see, these terrors are so dangerous that people are dropping like flies, because the Bible says in verse 7, he says, 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. Now, y'all miss your shout. You missed your shout right there. Listen, let me read it again, because that should have been your shout right there. Listen, he says, the dangers are coming. Terror is coming. Terror is coming by night. Terror is coming by day. Terror is coming by noontime. And then in verse 7, he says, 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come. Come on, hold on, no. You're missing me. Listen, 1,000 may fall at your side. 10,000 may fall at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Hold on, let's back up this one more time, because you still ain't got it. We're going to change that last pronoun at the end right there. 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near me. It shall not come near me. Why? Because I'm in the proximity of the Lord, and the Lord provides shelter for me. And when I see that the enemy is dropping like flies, but because I am in proximity with the Lord will cover me. The Lord will protect me. The Lord will be my shield and my buckler. That's why he will cover me today. He will cover you. But hold on for a second. But it's not because you are strong or healthy. It's not because you got your COVID shot. It's not because you are all that holy. But it's because verse 4 says, this is the reason. It says, he shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. The Lord knows how to hide me. When I'm going to stop when the enemy comes to get me sometimes. Yes, every now and then I might trip and fall of the enemy's arrow that he shoots me with. But when I stay close to the Lord will cover me. He will cover me. And you know what the Lord will do? The Lord will let folks pass right by you. They don't even see you because he's got you. He got you covered this morning. He's kind of, I really don't want to use this word this morning, Chris, but I got to use it. He'll cover you with his eagle's. With his eagle's wing, he'll cover you this morning. Is there anybody here this morning want to tell somebody, I'm covered this morning because I'm close with the Lord? You see, and under his wings, you can find refuge. Well, what do you mean, Pastor? Here's what I mean. The example for that is in Luke chapter 15, verse 20. The Bible says, Jesus says, and he arose and came to his father, talking about the prodigal son. But when he was yet a great ways off, his father saw him, had compassion, and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. In other words, what the prodigal son did, he came to the father. And when he came to the father had his arms out, stretched out wide, like an eagle's wings out. And the father embraced his boy. He put the boy in his arms. And because he had the boy in his arms, the boy now feels secure. The boy now feels like he's in a safe place. The boy now feels like he's welcome, because when you're close to your daddy, your daddy know how to cover you. When you get close to your daddy, your daddy knows what you need. When you get close to your daddy, your daddy know how to make you feel comfortable and at ease, because you're with your daddy. Well, this morning, I got to tell you that a little bit, something about me is that every now and then, I can be a neat freak when I'm at home. I can be a neat freak sometimes when I'm at home. And one of the stickers that I have as a neat freak is that, Gloria, when I get out of bed in the morning time, I got to make my bed up. I can't let my bed stay there all messed up. I know I'm getting back in it later on, but I got to make my bed up. And on the bed, Chuck, we got a sheet and we got a comforter on the bed right there. But every now and then, I might get in a hurry. Rhonda. But when I get in a hurry, what I'll do is I'll grab my sheet. I may not tuck it in real like it ought to be, real tight. I may put the other sheet that's on top. I may slide it up and don't tuck it in. But then I'll take my comforter and just throw it on the bed. It might not be real neat, but the comforter is on it. So you can't see that the sheet ain't tucked in. Why? Because the comforter is on top of the bed and all you see is the comforter. May the Lord bless you real good. But I want to let you know I've got a comforter. And my comforter knows how to comfort me. And when you don't know what's going on underneath, down on the inside of me, my comforter puts his comfort over me. And you know, he don't let you see what's happening down underneath, what's going on in my life. I pray the Lord bless you, that you have a good day. But may I tell you today, there are some perks. There are some privileges when you draw close to the Lord. That's why the hymnologist says, Jesus, keep me near the cross. For there's a precious fountain, free to all, a healing stream, flows from Calvary's mountain. But you are not let anybody or anything put a gulf between you and the Lord. And every now and then, the devil will try to put a wedge in between me. But I can't let him put that wedge in there because it's going to mess up my proximity with the Lord. I don't know about you. God's got some privileges for those who stay close to him. God got some perks for those who stay close to him. God got some favor for those who stay close to you. I don't know about you this morning, but I want to be in his favor. I want every perk that God has for me. I want every privilege that God has for me. But in order to get it, I got to stay under the umbrella of the Lord. You can't come between me and my God. I got too much to lose to let you come between me and my God. You can't stop my blessing because I'm going to block you from letting me get my blessing. That's why Jesus went to Calvary one day, so I could have the blessing that when I die, I'll have eternal life. And I get it all because I'm in proximity with the Lord. You ought to tell somebody this morning, don't get in between me and the Lord. I love you, but I can't let you get in between me and the Lord. Because I got some perks that I want to get from the Lord. Come on, stand. Come on. Had enough fun today. Come on. Stay close to the Lord. Stay in proximity with him. And some blessings will come your way. He who abides in the shadow of the Almighty, find their way to that secret place of God. There may be somebody here today. While you're here today, feel like you missed some privileges. You missed some perks. You see other folks getting perks and getting privileges from God, but you're not getting them. Maybe you haven't gotten closer today. And if you have not confessed Jesus as Lord of your life, you have not gotten close enough. He says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. He said, I'll give you rest. Rest from your weariness. Rest from your burdens. Rest. Sweet rest today. You can only get it in Jesus. If you're here, you're not saved. Come on. Come give your life to Christ. Come and become a candidate for baptism. Baptism, being baptized in the water, but most of all, being baptized in the Spirit of God. Why don't you come? You may be here, you don't have a church home, and you want to come and join the church this morning. We welcome you to come and join this morning. We want to be together as we are close to the Lord, close with each other in proximity with God. Is there one who would come today? Come to give your life to the Lord. Come to join the church today in the Spirit of holiness. Every head bowed. Don't worry about the music. I know we normally have music right here, but don't worry about that. Music won't get you to heaven. Amen. Only way you get to heaven is through Jesus Christ. Amen. And I ain't going to guarantee you there'll be some music playing when you go. Matter of fact, I don't need the music. I can make my own music.
I got a song in my heart. Amen. Father, thank you now for your word. I pray, God, I've done due diligence to your word today. I didn't misquote anything, God. Said it the way you wanted me to say it. Now come and bless your people. Somebody's trying to make a decision right now, and the enemy is saying no. But I pray, God, that you would tell the enemy, you're a liar. Devil, you're a liar. I'm saying yes to the Lord today. Thank you now for your spirit in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Come on, brother. Come on. Come on. Yes, sir. Oh, all right. Thank you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. Yes, yes, yes. That's right. I'm coming down. I'm coming down. Let me put my eyes on. That's all right. I'm coming down. I'm coming down. That's why we pray on Monday and on Friday mornings. We've been lifting your name up every Monday and every Friday morning. We've been lifting you up. We've been lifting you up. Amen. Come here. Come here, Diggins. Come here, Diggins. Where my other Diggins at? I got one more? Okay. I got Laverne. I need Shirley. All right. Where's Shirley? No Shirley? Okay. All right. Okay, she left. All right. All right. We're going to pray for her. We're going to pray for her. Amen. We're going to pray for her. All right. Come on, Diggins. Y'all Diggins. Come on. This is what fellowship is all about. It's what church is all about. Praying for one another. Praying for each other. All of us are going through something. If you tell somebody you ain't going through something, you lying. All of us are going through something. We're going to pray for my brother. We're going to pray in the name of Jesus. The Bible says that we have faith of a mustard seed. That we can speak to mountains and mountains will have to get out of our way. He has a mountain in front of him. He's been battling this disease, this illness. But look, he's still standing. He's still standing. That means God still got work. Got work for him. And we're going to pray that he continues to stand. And that body won't be racking with pain. His mind won't be tossed to and fro trying to figure out if this the end or what is it? No, no, no. Let him have a clear mind. Peace within his soul and his spirit this morning. And we're going to pray for Sister Shirley this morning. Whatever she's dealing with, that God will touch her right now in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to you right now. Come, God, leaning on your word. All we got is your word, God. So, God, we come leaning on your word. Your word says if there be any sick among us, let them call for the elders of the church. And let them pray, anointing with oil. And the prayer of faith will heal the sick. If there be any sin, sin shall be forgiven. So, God, we come praying for him, right? Praying for Brother Larry right now in the name of Jesus. God, that as he gets ready to go for his procedure on Friday, God, clear his mind right now in the name of Jesus. Let him know that you are right there with him. But then God, guide the hands of those who shall touch him with surgery or whatever preparation that is being made for this procedure, God. Praying that you would bless them, God, in a mighty, mighty way. That there be no mistakes made. There be no errors, God. Because you are orchestrating this. And so God, let him draw close to you right now. And let the privileges come his way. Let him come back with a testimony that God is our refuge and strength. Very present help in the time of trouble. So we thank you right now. And we speak life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God, for what you've done. Thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for what you're about to do in his life, God. And we claim the victory through Christ Jesus, our Lord, we pray. Amen. Amen. And amen. 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 Come on, let's praise God. Come on. Come on. We're thanking God for the victory right now. Don't wait till the battle is over to shout. You already know you're going to win. Praise God. Oh, my God. Praise God today. It's nothing like when the saints come together to pray for each other, that we can encourage somebody else going through something that others have already gone through. And if God bless others, he'll do the same thing for you. Amen. Come on, Brother Trustee. Come on, make the table ready as we prepare to give on today. We prepare to give on today. We give because God has already given. We give because he commands us to give. That we ought to bring the tithe, we ought to bring the offering to the storehouse. And he says, there's a blessing in that. He says, come on and prove me. So I can show you that I'll open up windows in heaven and I'll pour you out blessings. You won't have room enough to receive. So we've come this morning that we can give unto the Lord on this day. Amen. Come on, can we all stand as we read our offertory litany this morning? We read this in agreement with one another, agreement with what the Lord's word says. It's offering time. It's time to bring our tithes and offerings.
Praise the Lord.
Who, to whom, come on, get back to that. Get back to that. You're in the wrong spot. Okay, now go. To whom does the tithe belong? Okay, you're messing me up, Rhonda. You're messing up. Go ahead. Okay, we all right now. Come on. Who should tithe?
Everyone should tithe.
All right. Why should we tithe?
Because God has been in my heart, and the church needs resources.
How much should we tithe?
We are to give
the
church all in our heart, but the tithe means
10. What is God's promise to us when we tithe? What kind of giver does the Lord love? God loves a cheerful giver. Amen. We're going to play some music now, right? And the ushers are going to march. Y'all not going to march today. Okay, y'all got pretty today. Y'all ain't going to march today. All right. Give them some anyway. Oh, there you go. Well, y'all look good anyway. All right. Got your pink on today. Wear it again next week. Read again next week. Amen. Okay. All right, come on, y'all. Turn the music up a little bit for me, please. Like we're at a party. This is a party. We're trying to celebrate. You can't celebrate with the soft music. Come on. There you go. Yeah, walk lively, walk lively, walk lively, walk lively, amen, yes, yes. We thank you now, God, for the great things that you have done. Thank you, God, for the things that you have done and that in which you are doing. We ask right now that you bless our gifts that we have brought to you today. And God, that you would bless our gifts that we have given to you on this day. And bless this storehouse called Mount Lebanon Baptist Church. That we will use the gifts that you have given here on this day for the edifying thy kingdom down here on earth. God, we thank you, we love you, and we praise you for the gift and the giver. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 God bless you. Thank you so kindly for all those who have come to be here with us on today. And we're just so grateful for how God is still blessing and God is still keeping us. On next Sunday is fourth Sunday, and as Sister Yule has announced, we're going to wear pink, so I got to get some pink to go along with my jersey color. I don't want to tell you my jersey color, but I got to get a little pink to go with it. It's not black, and it's not gold. It is not burgundy or things untold. Yeah, you got it. You got it. God bless each of you. May you go in peace on this day with the love of Jesus in your heart. Let's every head bowed. Father, thank you now for the time that you've given us to share with your people today. I pray, God, that we will trust in your word, knowing that your word is true. Let your word sink down in our heart, God, to draw us closer to you. Let us be in proximity to your privileges and your perks that you have for those who dwell in the secret place of the Almighty. We love you and we thank you. Now unto him who's able to keep you from falling, who's able to present you faultless before his throne with exceeding glad joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be dominion, power, majesty, now, henceforth, and forevermore. And all those who love the Lord say amen. 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 And amen. God bless you. God bless you.